Blastoise.
What is going on, fellow packbusters? The dog's going nuts. Yep, that's not Christy.
Nope.
Ugly mug, that's not her. But yeah, Eric's back with us. He procured some Champion's Path, so we're going to open up a booster box, Champion's Path, with Eric today. Going to be awesome. And he's going to rip into them. We'll show you the cards, and you know what? We're just going to have a grand old time right now. Tons of these openings. The set's super small. I think everybody knows my take on the set. It's just kind of all over the place, and the cuts have been really bad so far, centering, etc. So,
oh, nice. There you go. I'm sorry.
He's not used to this. So,
nope,
sure ain't. But, yeah, the, I haven't seen too many of the Charizards pulled yet, but, you know, from what I have seen, the cuts have not been perfect, and like Hidden Fates, it is super repetitive. Oh, you gotta give me all those, bro. What are you doing?
There you go.
I'm like, you got to quit. He's cheating over here. He's just like putting them down like he's opening them without the camera over here. Got it, all sorts of craziness. All right. There's that. Here is your code card. We're going to get him to get this right. But there you go. Gold Kabu or the Rainbow Kabu. Here, you just open them and hand it to me. And then you can watch up on the big screen.
Mm-hmm.
You're going to have like all sorts of craziness, I think.
Possibly.
Tweedle! It does get super crazy, but it is a booster box worth today. Trubbish and Eldegoss, which is a reprint. So a lot of these cards have been seen already in previous sets, so that's kind of a bummer.
Are these from Sun and Moon sets, or these?
No, these are all from the first three. Like the artwork and everything is from.
Oh, okay.
And we got Altaria Hollow. There's your code card. So that was a bummer. I was hoping for some newer art and whatnot, but we did not get it. Excuse me.
Bless you.
But we got Hatterin, Sharpedo, Hatena, Galarian Lanoon, Scraggy, Purloin, Absol, and another Marnie. And every pack has a holo. So code card colors do not matter. I'm going to give you this. Hush!
Looks like the guts have actually been looking pretty good.
No, on the ultra rares.
Oh, really?
Yeah. So the dogs are going nuts. Full heal and Cenoscorch. Right, here we go. There we go. Right, 1, 2, 3, 4. Let's see here. Kakuna, Hatena, Inkay, Swablu. You can enjoy the cards. Huh? He's opening them faster than I can show them. Oh, there we go, Gardevoir.
That's a pretty one.
It is a pretty card.
Yes. I think all those cards are great.
All right. I may, we're going to go through the, depending on how fast he is opening these things. There's your code card. We may just Dariums this up and just show the last two. But we will see. I kind of like the suspense in the beginning.
Mm-hmm.
Because you never know what's going to happen. Oh, I just jacked that up. Whatever.
Either way, they'll see it.
Bull picks. Rough. We got phones ringing and Galarian Cursalos. Right. Here we go. But how's everybody else doing with Champion's Path? Were people able to find it? Because I have been hearing it's been darn near impossible to find in stores. So
I think impossible is an understatement.
But, yep, hopefully everybody found some. We should have more available in October. So hit me up in the email down below. We're not going to have ETBs, but we will have packs and collections. Ooh, that's pretty. Grapplock V.
That is awesome. Is that the alternate art?
Yes, that's the full art. Yep. Just the full art. So they don't do the alternate arts in...
Okay, the full art.
Yeah. Anymore. What do we got here?
Mm-hmm. There's something in that one.
There is. Did you look at it already?
No, I did not.
I just felt it.
I know you did. I saw the glimmer on it, and I was like, ooh.
You know what I think it is? I think it's going to be the hot full art. That's my guess. That was great. It's the only full art. I think it might be the only full art trainer in here. That's why. So Addison pulled that in the video. We're filming this on Friday, so the video that goes up on Friday, Addison pulled that out of her ETB. So go.
Oh, really?
Check that out. Weedle, Zigzagoon, Roly Coly, Machoke, and another Cinnasquirch. Right, here you go. Can Eric pulled two shiny Charizards, right?
Two shinies.
From Hidden Fates.
Yes.
So he does have that Charizard luck. So there is a possibility.
And four from the previous, from Darkness. And
you got four from Darkness Ablaze. All four of them came back PSA 10s.
Yes.
Unfortunately, as the days go on, the card continues to go down. The Charizards in this set, especially the Rainbow Rare, is like just made that card not as desirable anymore. That and so many of them are coming back from PSA now. And that card just seemed to grade really, really well. Ah, another Obstagoon. Here we go. How fast can we open a booster box? Here we go. Beedrill, Great Ball, Sonia, Full Heal, Scraggy, Snake, Nickit, Milo, and a Marnie.
She was pretty plentiful in the last one, wasn't she? No, that was
the first set.
Was it? Yep. Sword.
Yep. Yeah. The base set. So, those of you that watch us quite often know that I am very, very excited for Vivid Voltage. Also, new news this week: the next special set has been announced for February. The new 25th anniversary Pokemon set. So we are looking forward to that. Hopefully, it falls in line with the new Shiny Vault set coming out in Japan in November. That would be cool. If not, what I really want to see is us get the Tag All-Stars cards that we have yet to see. I don't care if we don't have GXs in play anymore. Like, you know, GXs really aren't the thing, or they're kind of going out because the V cards are a little bit more powerful. But I definitely would love to see those cards in English, especially the what's it called, the golds. So the gold Tribirds, the gold Charizard, the Mew and Mewtwo in gold, all that stuff would be awesome. So that's what I would like to see. But with Pokemon, you never can tell what it's gonna happen. This card's gonna tank in price too. It's holding pretty steady around $5-6.
Yeah.
And it's just not going to hold its value because you're just going to find them everywhere in this set. Ooh, there's something in here.
Uh-oh.
Potion, Vulpix, Inkay, Pokeball, Slizipede. We're almost two-thirds of the way through. Oh, Patrim, yeah. Sonia, Beedrill. Oh, Gardevoir V-Max.
Pretty, pretty card.
It is very pretty. All right, there's that one. They do look good.
Yes, they do.
I'll tell you that. The artwork is awesome. All right, what are we going to get? What are we going to get? What are we going to get? I like the art on this Beedrill card, too. We do have a birdie thing that's not a dragon anymore. All right, here we go. Here we go, here we go, here we go. You got a rainbow. You got a full art trainer.
Yep.
You did pretty good. The pull rates have been kind of all over the place. Some people are like, oh, I just opened a double box and I got the shiny Charizard, or I got the Rainbow Rare Zard. And then other people have, I think Darium's opened like 75 packs for somebody the other night.
You didn't get one.
And it was like, it really wasn't that many hits, period. So,
wow.
Like, there's a lot of just regular Vs, but in terms of like rainbows and full arts and stuff like that, it was pretty miss.
Yeah, look at Professor's Research back in there. That's cool.
Yeah, it's back too. It's good because like a lot of these cards, people just didn't get into the other sets. I mean, they're highly playable. It's nice that they're back and more people can get their hands on them. But I mean, come on, at least give us a new artwork. Like Hop was in the last set, right? Got a new artwork. Yeah, so much better. Piers, Professor.
Wasn't that the same exact one?
It was. Hmm. Like, what is going on? We got a Snake. We got a Weedle. We got a Linoon. A Scraggy. A Roly Coly. Energy. Sonia. Sharpedo.
Obstagoon.
In a whole lot of nothing. All right. There's that. We got it. We got it. We got it. Here we go.
Yeah.
Super repetitive. It's all right. This is a gold card. That can of food is the only gold card in this.
Really? Yeah. That's hilarious.
Hakuna Matata. Weeful.
A can of food.
And a Marnie.
So they did basically did this like they did Hidden Fates. Just put the green, all green and white cards.
Correct. Correct. But Hidden Fates, you didn't get a guaranteed holo in every pack.
Like, oh, yeah.
This is like Dragon's Majesty and Shining Legends was where you got at least a holo in every pack.
Oh, that's cool.
Rotom Bike and another.
Man, that Obstagoon, well, he's very popular.
Another Obstagoon. Come on. Come on, Pokemon.
I know, right?
Let's get Eric some stuff. Snake. Energy. Victini. Machoke. Kakuna.
Nothing. Hakuna Matata nothing.
Lots of code cards for the code card goblin things. Yeah. All right. Roly-Coly. So Eric was really hoping that our allocations were going to come through because he did not get these from us. And we were going to do a gigantic, like, we were planning on wanting to do, like, a 100-pack opening, but obviously everybody knows how shafted everybody got on allocations, and we just couldn't do it.
Yeah.
Maybe near the end we've gotten enough.
Maybe if it comes back through and we can get us, I'll just still do a whole case break.
Oh, Obstagoon. Come on now. Come on now.
Well, just have to play it by ear.
Yep. No rush. This is not going away anytime soon. Everybody's making the mad dash right now because the singles prices are super high. I think the Rainbow Rare Charizard somewhere between, I think the like ones at auction as of us making this video, the highest bid is like $2,000 right now, raw. So obviously none of them are graded, but yeah, it's a little ridiculous. So you know that the market's going to get flooded. There's a lot more product coming out. And what's that?
Something on this one.
Ooh. So
ooh, shiny too.
Alright, so let's see here. But yeah. Like hold off. Like I know everybody wants ETVs and if you can find them, find them. But like if you're just wanting packs to open, hold like you know, chill for just a minute, because you will get it. It's gonna be out there. We didn't think we were getting more Hidden Fates last year. They re-released tins, they did the Walmart exclusive boxes. Like, you're going to see a lot of crazy stuff. Like, don't be surprised if you see a new product that hasn't, not necessarily the Walmart boxes, but, like, an actual, like, pre-orderable product that hasn't been discussed yet. Like, don't be surprised if that ends up happening as, like, one more bonus item.
Oh, wow.
And you're going to see stuff. It's going to be out there. They're not going to, trust me, it's a cash cow. They got us by the giblets right now, and in mad dashing for the stuff. And
hopefully, this is a good one.
Ooh, yeah, it's got some. You know what it is? It's another hop.
You think?
Yep. Damn. That's my guess. My guess is another Hip Hop Anonymous. I may be wrong.
I hope. Damn it.
So, but not too bad. I mean, 36 packs. You're right about average. Two full art hops. Got the Gardevoir V Max. We got Graplock V full art. You did get the Kabu Rainbow, which is really nice. And then you got 5 regulars. So not too bad. Not too shabby. Out of a booster box's worth of stuff. I'll give you those because you haven't seen those yet. But thanks everybody for chilling out and watching with us and seeing what's up, and you know, happy Champions Path hunting. Hit us up in the email down below. I know. Talked with the distributor today, and there's going to be more product. So there's a lot more regular releases still to come, and then like there will be reprints. So just keep in touch with us if you want it. We're going to hold true to our pricing all the way through. So $4 a pack for loose packs, and then MSRP on everything else, except for, that's it, because we're not going to be having any more ETBs. But let us know if you're looking for stuff. And thanks, Eric, for joining us. That was a quick 15-minute booster box, but happy pack busting, everybody.
Have a good one.